After studying this module, you shall be able to know the concept of cash and cash equivalent, know the concept of operating, investing, and financing activities, identify the various types of cash activities, learn how to prepare cash flow statement, analyze the business ability to earn cash flows. The balance sheet depicts the overall financial position of the entity, including the level of cash balance and also the amount available at bank. The income statement reflects the profits earned during the period, but there is no perfect correlation between profit and level of cash. For example, a business entity may have earned profit of rupees 50 lakhs, but due to heavy credit sales and poor collection policies, there may be a significant increase in debtors and bills receivable. In this case, there is huge profit, but the level of cash will be very low. The financial statements of the business firm fail to answer the question that why an enterprise is left with very little cash despite earning huge profits. The simple cash book shows receipts and payments during the year, but it does not reveal the way in which reporting enterprise has generated cash and the way they were utilized during the accounting period. The cash flow statement is an appropriate method which answers all these questions. Therefore, the need for inclusion of summary of cash receipts and payments in financial statement of reporting enterprise is recognized. Cash flow statement. A cash flow statement is a summary of cash inflows and cash outflows arising out of various activities, usually classified as operating, investing, and financing. It is prepared as per accounting standard 3. It is additional information which is provided to the users of financial statements. The statement is an inevitable tool in the hands of investor to assess the liquidity and solvency of the business firm. The cash generating and its utilization ability can be accessed with the help of the statement. The cash flow statement means the statement showing the manner in which the level of cash has changed with due comparison of profits earned in corresponding period. Objectives of cash flow statement. The basic objective of the statement is to disseminate information about the actual movement of cash during a period, duly analyzing it in terms of various types of cash activities. The accounting standard 3 states the following objectives of cash flow statement for the users of financial statements. 1. To provide information about the changes in cash and cash equivalents through operating, investing, and financing activities. 2. To assess and determine the ability of the enterprise to generate or produce cash and cash equivalents. Difference between cash book and cash flow statement. Although these are based on the same set of information, but these two are totally different from each other in the following manner. You see the table which has two columns. One is talking about cash book. Cash book, it is a book of original entry. It records cash transactions throughout the year as and when the transaction occurs. It is one of the important components of financial accounting system. The cash inflows and outflows are not classified into subheadings. The cash flow statement, on the other hand, it is a part of financial statement. It is prepared at the end of the year. It assists in decision making for the management. The cash flows are classified as operating, investing, and financing activities. Meaning of cash and cash equivalent. In relation to cash flow statement, the term cash comprises cash on hand and demand deposits with banks. Cash equivalents are short-term, highly liquid investments that are readily convertible into known amounts of cash and which are subject to a significant risk of changes in value. The basic purpose of holding cash equivalents is to meet out the short-term cash commitments and never for investment purposes. An investment normally qualifies as a cash equivalent only when it has a short maturity of say 3 months or less from the date of acquisition. Investments in shares are normally excluded from cash equivalents unless they are in substance cash equivalents. Cash and cash equivalents is calculated in the following manners. You see the particulars: cash in hand, cash at bank, marketable securities, less bank overdraft, less cash credit. This gives cash and cash equivalent. Meaning of cash flows. Cash flows are inflows and outflows of cash and cash equivalent within bracket CCE. It is important to note that there may be movements within the component of CCE. For example, if cash has been withdrawn from bank for office use, then although it is an item of flow, but it is not considered as flow in CFS. This flow is for internal management relating to cash rather than a specific activity. It is important to note that management of cash includes the investment of excess cash or cash equivalents. The following are some of the examples wherein the movement is between items of CCE. Number one, cash deposited into bank. Number two, cash withdrawn from bank. Number three, purchase of marketable securities which are neither held as current assets nor held as investments. The cash flow arises when the net effect of transaction is either to increase or decrease the amount of CCE. There may be some transactions where CCE may not be affected. For example, number one, acquisition of non-current asset on long-term deferred payment basis. Number two, bills receivables received from debtors. Number three, issue of fully paid up bonus shares. Number four, writing of bad debts against provision made for doubtful debtors. Number five, charging depreciation on non-current assets. Major classification of cash flows. The usual way of classification of cash flows is inflow, that is within bracket cash receipts, and cash outflows, that is cash payments. In cash flow statement, this classification is further divided into following major categories: A, operating activities; B, investing activities; C, financing activities. Cash flows from operating activities. Operating activities are the principal revenue producing activities of the enterprise and other activities that are not investing or financing activities. Cash flow from these activities are primarily derived from principal revenue producing activities of the enterprise. For example, for a trading entity, the main revenue producing operating activities include sale of goods and services. Similarly, if advances are made by financial enterprises, then these are operating activities. For these entities, as it is their main revenue producing activity. So, the nature and type of entity is relevant. But there are certain payments which are always classified as operating activities for all types of enterprises, like salaries, wages, etc. There is a need to ascertain whether the firm is able to generate sufficient amount of cash from its business operations. For example, if a firm has sold an asset at rupees 15 lakh and there is net outflow in business operations for rupees 14 lakhs, the net flow indicates rupees 1 lakh as inflow, which is not realistic because these inflows are not sustainable in long run. Therefore, in order to judge the real profitability of the business, there is a need to determine the cash from operating separately. The example of this kind of cash flows are following. A. Cash receipts from the sale of goods, services. B. Cash receipts from royalties, fees, commissions, and other revenue. C. Cash payments to suppliers for goods and services. D. Cash payment for all operating expenses. E. Cash receipts and cash payments of insurance enterprise for premiums and claims, annuities, and other policy benefits. And 6. Cash payments or refunds of income taxes. Cash flows from investing activities. Investing activities include the acquisition and disposal of long-term assets such as land, building, equipment, etc., not held for resale in ordinary course of business. These activities also include the purchase and sale of other investments. The securities with maturity period of less than 3 months are treated as part of CCE. So the investment activities are those which are related to the investment of funds in the fixed assets and other investments. The examples are A. Purchase of fixed assets, intangibles, etc. B. Sale of fixed assets and intangibles for cash. C. Acquisition of shares, warrants, debentures, etc. D. Cash receipts from disposal of shares, warrants, or debt instruments of other enterprises and interest in joint ventures. E. Cash inflows or outflows regarding advances and loans made or repayment thereof. F. Cash receipts by way of interest, dividend, or any other cash income from the investee enterprise. Cash flows from financing activities. Financing activities are activities that result in changes in the size and composition to the owner's capital, including preference share capital in case of a company, and borrowings of the enterprise. The cash flow from financing activities is ascertained by analyzing the changes in equity, share capital, preference share capital, debentures, and other borrowings. The examples are A. Cash proceeds from issuing shares or other similar instruments. B. Cash proceeds from issuing debentures, notes, and bonds. C. Cash proceeds from other short or long-term borrowings. D. redemption of preference shares. E, repayments of amounts borrowed. F, interest or dividend payments. Significant non-cash transactions. There may be some non-cash transactions. There may be some related activities which do not involve the movement of cash, like purchase of land by issue of debentures. Technically, these are investing and financing activities. But there is no place in cash flow statement for this transaction, and therefore they do not appear in CFS. Such transactions should be disclosed elsewhere in the financial statements. The examples are: A, the acquisition of assets by assuming directly related liabilities. B, the acquisition of enterprise by means of issue of shares. And C, the conversion of debt to equity. Methods of preparation of cash flow statement. There are two methods of finding out cash flow from operating activities. These are A, the direct method, or B, the indirect method. Direct method. Under the direct method, the net cash flow from operating activities is found and other items in the statement of profit and loss for: 1. Changes during the period in inventories and operating receivables and payables. 2. Other non-cash items. And 3. Other items for which the cash effects are investing of financing cash flows. Indirect method. In this method, the net profit reflected by statement of profit and loss is the starting point. But the profit and loss account includes some non-cash items like depreciation, loss on sale of assets, etc. There may be certain non-operating items like debentures interest paid, interest received on investment, etc. These are adjusted in the given amount of net profit in order to arrive at cash generated from operations. The actual amount of tax paid is deducted and adjustments are made for extraordinary items. The resultant is called as cash from operating activities. There is no difference in computation of other two types of activities. Format of cash flow statement. Indirect method of preparation of CFS for the year ending. The format is something like as shown in the table. A, cash flows from operating activities. The items are net profit before taxation, excluding extraordinary profit and loss. Adjustment for non-cash items. Add depreciation, primary expenses, written off, etc. Items treated separately. This is to be added loss on sale of investments and fixed assets. You have to add interest expenses and then deduct gain on sale of investments in fixed assets and deduct interest income. This will give you operating profit before working capital changes. To this, you have to add decrease in accounts receivables, debtors, inventory, prepaid expenses, advance, etc. Plus, increase in accounts payable, creditors, accrued liability, provision, etc. Minus increase in accounts receivables, debtors, inventory, prepaid expenses, advances, etc. Minus decrease in accounts payable, creditors, accrued liability, provision, etc. Cash generated from operations, from this you deduct income tax paid. This will give net cash from operating activities plus profit or loss from extraordinary activities. B. Cash flows from investing activities. Deduct from this purchase of fixed assets, investments. Deduct loans and advances given, but add back sale of fixed assets and investments. Add back loans and advances received back. Add interest and dividend received. B. Net cash available from investing activity if a plus sign. C. Net cash used if minus in investing activities. C. Cash flows from financing activities. We have to add proceeds from issuance of share capital, oblique debentures, loans, public deposit taken. Deduct from this repayment of preference capital, debentures, loans, public deposit, minus interest paid, dividends paid. It gives us net cash flow if positive, used if minus in financing activities. Net increase, oblique decrease in cash and cash equivalents is A plus B plus C. Cash and cash equivalents at beginning of period and cash equivalents at end of the period. Direct method of preparation of CFS for the year ending dash dash dash. Item A in the above cash flow statement will be replaced by following, and the other items B and C will remain the same. A. Cash flows from investing activities. Cash received from customers. Deduct from this cash paid to suppliers. Minus cash paid to employees. Minus other cash payments for overhead and other expenses. CGO or cash generated from operations, and from this it deduct income taxes paid. Cash flow from operating activities plus profit and minus loss from extraordinary activities. Total cash available from operating activities will be arrived at. Note, minus figures will be indicated by writing them in brackets in cash flow statements. Practical illustrations. Illustration 8.1. For a manufacturing company, give examples of 1. Inflows of cash receipts from operating activities within bracket CFOA. Number 2. Outflows of investing activities CFIA. Answer. 1. Inflows of CFOA are cash sale of goods, cash receipts from rendering of services, refund of income tax, royalties received, fees and commission received. Outflows of CFIA are acquisition of fixed assets on cash basis, loans advanced to third parties, purchase of shares for cash. Illustration 8.2. Consider following information and prepare a statement showing flow of cash of MX Limited. Balance sheet as on 31/3/2014, 31/3/2014. Liabilities, share capital 5 lakhs, 6 lakhs. Reserves 1,50,000, 1,80,000. Profit and loss account 40,000, 65,000. Debentures, 3 lakhs, 2,50,000. Creditors, 1,70,000, 1,60,000. Provision for tax, 60,000, 80,000. Assets, gross block, 10 lakhs, 11,20,000. Depreciation, 3,70,000, 4,60,000. Net block, 6,30,000, 6,60,000. Stock, 2,40,000, 3,70,000. Book debts, 2,50,000, 2,30,000. Cash and bank balance, 80,000, 60,000. Miscellaneous expenditure, discount on shares, 10,000, 7,500. Primary expenses, 10,000, 7,500. The total of assets and liabilities is shown for the 2 years as 12,20,000, 13,35,000. Similarly, for liabilities, 12,20,000, 13,35,000. Profit and loss appropriation account for the year ended 31/3/2015. Particulars, rupees. To reserves, 30,000. By balance brought down is 40,000. To interim dividend paid, 80,000. To balance carried to balance sheet, 65,000. Total of this is 1,75,000. By net profit for current year, 1,35,000. Now, let's look at the solution. MX Limited cash flow statement for the year ended 31st March 2015. Cash flow from operating activities. In the middle column, you see the number 1,35,000. Net profit before tax, add back depreciation, which is the difference of 4,60,000 minus 3,70,000, which is 90,000. Discount on issue of shares written off, 2,500. Preliminary expenses written off, 2,500. Provision for tax, 80,000. Total of this comes to 1,75,000. Operating profit before working capital changes is total of 3,10,000. From this, we will deduct increase in stock, 1,30,000, decrease in creditors, 10,000. So total deductions are 1,40,000. This gives us operating profit, 1,70,000. To this, we will add decrease in book debts, 20,000. So the cash generated from operations come to 1,90,000. From this, we will deduct income tax paid of 60,000, and net cash generated from operating activities is shown in the last column as 1,30,000. Number two, cash flow from investing activities. Fixed assets purchased, 1,20,000. Again, you see it is in the bracket, that means there is an outflow of cash. So net cash used in investing activities, 1,20,000. Cash flow from financing activities. Issue of shares, 1 lakh. Redemption of debentures, 50,000. Interim dividend paid, 80,000. Net cash used in financing activities comes to 30,000. Net decrease in cash is 20,000. Opening balance of cash and cash equivalent is 80,000. And closing balance of cash and cash equivalent is 60,000. So you see the two are tallied. Illustrations 8.3. The balance sheet of New Light Limited for the years ended 31st March 2014 and 2015 are as follows. So look at the liabilities and assets for the years 2014-2015. Equity share 12 lakh 16 lakhs. 10% preference share 4 lakh 20 thousand, 3 lakh. Capital reserve 40,000. General reserves 6 lakh 60 thousand, 7 lakh 80 thousand. Profit and loss account 2 lakh 50 thousand, 3 lakh 10 thousand. 9% debentures 3 lakh 90 thousand, 2 lakh 70 thousand. Current liabilities 4 lakh 40 thousand, 4 lakh 80 thousand. Proposed dividend 1 lakh 20 thousand, 1 lakh 40 thousand. Provision for tax 4 lakh, 3 lakh 80 thousand. Unpaid dividend 20,000. The total for the 2 years comes to 38 lakh 80 thousand and 43 lakh 20 thousand. The assets are as under: fixed assets 32 lakhs, 38 lakhs, less depreciation 9 lakh 20 thousand, 11 lakh 60 thousand. The net block will come to 22 lakh 80 thousand and 26 lakh 40 thousand. Investments are 3 lakh 80 thousand, 3 lakhs. Cash balance 30,000, 30,000. Other current assets 11 lakhs, 13 lakhs. Primary expenses 90,000, 50,000. Total comes to 38 lakh 80 thousand and 43 lakh 20 thousand. Additional information. During the year, a fixed assets original cost 2 lakhs and accumulated depreciation 80,000 was sold for cash at rupees 1 lakh. There is an obsolete fixed assets costing 56,000 with accumulated depreciation of 40,000. It has been scrapped during the current year. The company has provided rupees 3 lakh 60 thousand as depreciation for the current year. The company has disposed of investment having book value of rupees 80,000 for rupees 1 lakh 20 thousand. The profit of 40,000 was transferred to the credit of capital reserve. Debentures and preference share capital redeemed at 5% premium. It was the practice of the company to value its inventory at 10% below its cost. Accordingly, the stock was valued at 2,60,000 on 31/3/2014. But from 1/4/2014, the policy was changed and opening inventory on 1/4/2014 was taken at cost. Similarly, the closing stock on 31/3/2015 was correctly valued as per new policy at rupees 3 lakhs. Considering the provisions of AS 3 revised, you are required to prepare cash flow statement. Solution: New Light Limited cash flow statement for the year ended 31st March 2015. 1. Cash flow from operating activities within bracket CFOA. Net profits before tax and FOI 6,48,000. Add back preliminary expenses written off 40,000. Depreciation on fixed assets 3,60,000. Loss on sale 20,000 plus 16,000, 36,000. Debenture interest 36,000. Now operating profit before working capital changes comes to 11,20,000. Less net increase in current assets is 1,76,000. To this add increase in current liabilities, which is 40,000. This gives us cash generated from operations at 9,84,000. From this, we will deduct income tax, which is paid at 3,60,000. So the net cash generated from operating activities is 6,24,000. Cash flow from investing activities, CFIA. Sale of fixed assets, 1 lakh. Fixed assets purchased, 8,56,000. Sale of investment, 1,20,000. So the net cash used in investing activities is 6,36,000. 3. Cash flow from financing activities, CFOA. Dividend paid, 1 lakh. Redemption of preference shares, 1,26,000. Redemption of debentures, 1,26,000. Issue of equity share capital, 4 lakh. Debenture interest paid, 36,000. So there is a net inflow of 12,000. The net change in cash is nil. Opening balance of CCE is 30,000. Closing balance of CCE is 30,000. Now look at the working notes for this particular cash flow statement. Profit and loss appropriation account. What you get by balance brought down from P&L account, 2,50,000. To this, you deduct proposed dividend, 1,40,000. General reserve, 1,20,000. To PPR, 6,000 plus 6,000 is 12,000. And the balance carried down is 3,10,000. On the right hand side, to the balance brought down, we will add by stock 24,000. By profit after tax, 3,08,000. The total of both the sides comes to 5,76,000. Fixed assets account. To balance brought down 32 lakhs. On the left hand side, we see to bank balancing figure 8,56,000. By bank, we get 1 lakh. By provision for depreciation, 80,000. By profit and loss account, 20,000. By provision for depreciation, 40,000. By profit and loss account, 16,000. And by balance carried down is 38 lakhs. The total for both the sides is 40,56,000. By balance brought down, 9,20,000. Add to this depreciation, 3,60,000. The total of this is 12,80,000. Now look at the left hand side. To fixed assets account, 80,000. To fixed asset account, again 40,000. And to balance carried down is 11,60,000. The total comes to 12,80,000. The balance sheet depicts the overall financial position, and the profit and loss account reflects the profits made, but there is no perfect correlation between the profits earned and amount of cash. A CFS is a summary of cash inflows and cash outflows arising out of various activities, usually classified as operating, investing, and financing. The basic objective of statement of cash flow is to provide information about entities operating, investing, and financing activities during the accounting period. The term cash comprises cash on hand and demand deposits with banks. Cash equivalents are short-term, highly liquid investments that are readily convertible into known amounts of cash and which are subject to a significant risk of changes in value. Cash flows are inflows and outflows of cash and cash equivalents. The cash flows of an entity are classified into operating, investing, and financing.